Hello world, welcome back to the Wars of our channel. So since Flappy Bird has been taken down from the App Store, people have been forced to look for Flappy Bird alternatives. Now, of course, because Flappy Bird was so popular, there is no shortage of Flappy Bird clones, and there's actually some very good games, some very good Flappy Bird-like games out there in the App Store. Some of them, like Juggling Balls, were created by the creator of Flappy Bird. Others like Iron Pants, Iron Pants is a complete clone of Flappy Bird, but it's well made. Then there's this piece of shit, Flappy Birdie. Let's start playing this game so you can see what I'm talking about. Oh, this is sadly, tragically, the number one game on the App Store right now. First of all, it works the same way as Flappy Bird. You just tap, but of course, it's not really a challenge like Flappy Bird because you can see the pipes are really open. The gaps between the pipes are really open. But then, okay, you know, one thing is, you know, an easier version of Flappy Bird. You know, that's acceptable. You can do that. But then it's just the quality. Oh my god, I just crashed there again, but I have 3 lives, so there you go. The quality of how it's made, it's horrible. Like, you can actually tell, it reminds me of those pirate games that you see often up, that often make their way to the App Store. You know, you remember the Dragon Ball Z pirate game, oh my god, and I lost lives. There you go. My high score is 60. I got a 49 here. Of course, I've never done that in Flappy Bird. But you remember also like the Minion Rush pirate game. It reminds me of those, and you can always tell a bad quality game because usually you can still see like your top the top bar of your cell phone. I mean, like the carrier, your Wi-Fi, your time, your battery. Usually, in these very low quality games, you can still see that while playing the game. But oh my god, thing is, it feels like it's so like whoever did this is so like stupid. It's I mean, one thing is, I don't know. I mean, I guess you need to have like a certain level of intelligence to make games. But then you see like such horrible taste. At least, like, who makes that background? What about that like the music? Like, everything is so. Then again, you know, this guy is laughing all the way to the bank because this game is the number one. Crap. Oh, there you go. New high score, 62. Oh no. Come on. I was ready. So I tapped, right? And they trick you. They actually trick you to click on the ad because you tap, right? That's how you start the game. And in order for you not to die, you need to tap again. But then they display an ad, so they tricked you to click in that ad. Wow, you sneaky piece of crap, person who made this. Wow, I'm amazed. Actually, let's pause the game. Actually, I wanted to... whatever. There you go. Silence the freaking music. Jesus, horrible music. At least I can silence it. But yeah, this guy's laughing all the way to the bank. He doesn't care. He's created a horrible product. I mean, why? So why is this game? Let's try to find an answer for this. Why is this lesser quality Flappy Bird clone the top game? Probably because it made the simple design choice of putting a freaking bird on the freaking icon and on the name. They call it very similar to Flappy Bird, Fly Birdie, and you know, that's enough, I guess. People are looking for Flappy Bird, they'll take the second best thing. Also, you know what's actually behind this? I feel there's a lot of kind of like tricking the algorithm. You see it a lot where with these like pirate type games, just like these spam games, really. that they will have like the longest titles ever. And I think that has to do a lot with like the way, I don't know, the App Store algorithm ranks a game. So I feel like there's a lot of, you know, gaming the App Store algorithm, you know, the fact that you know, there's a bird, and then, you know, I don't know, just creating this piece of crap game. I've been my best score, though. So, I don't know, this is what the creator of Flappy Bird has forces to, to, I don't know, play, I guess, because there's, you can't download Flappy Bird anymore. If you never downloaded Flappy Bird, or if you deleted it in a fit of rage, you're stuck with these craps. Actually, you're not stuck with this. People buy it because they see it at the top of the of search results. By, you know, Iron Pants. You know, I hate Iron Pants compared to Flappy Bird, but oh my god, Iron Pants is heaven compared to this. Or even, maybe even better, is it Juggling Balls or Juggling Ball? I don't know. Regardless, it's what she said. I lost. What? I'm done playing this game. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up. Be sure to check out the videos below. Subscribe to the channel. There's also a bunch of other Flappy Bird options out there. Do not download this game. It's horrible. Jesus. Oh my god. I hate how sneaky this game is. But thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.